Okay, everybody, welcome back. This is a little mini lesson we're going to do talking about how to use templates. And we're going to spend a lot of time today in our editor and browser basically working together to build a few templates in a simple web application. So let's start with what a basic web application looks like. Here we have a basic little web application. This is effectively the hotel world homework that you did from the first lesson. And you know, as you can see, it doesn't really do much. It's got one handler on slash called main page, which is here. And all it does is it prints the string hello Udacity. I've made my main page handler inherit from a class called handler, which I've defined up here. And this just adds one method called write. And all write is, it just lets me print a string without having to type self response.out.write. I can just type in self .write. And we'll be adding a few more helper functions to this handler as we go. So we've got this basic file here. We've got this basic app.yaml. You know, nothing crazy here. This should all be familiar to you by now. Let's go ahead and make sure this works. We'll go to our terminal. I'm in the template lesson directory where these files are, as you can see. We'll run the app server like so. I prefer to run the app server from the terminal so I can just see what's going on and I can kill it easily. It's telling me we're running at localhost 8080. So let's go ahead and check that out on our browser. We'll go to localhost 8080, load this page, and we see our text that I typed, hello Udacity. Let's just make sure everything is working as expected. I'm just going to change this string, adding a few exclamation marks. I'll save this file, and then we'll go back to our browser and reload and just make sure that everything is working end to end. Okay, here I am in the browser. I reload. My extra exclamation marks appeared. So we're all good there. Now, in this lesson, I'm going to ask you lots of questions like what happens when you do X or Y or whatever. So try to follow along with me as we go. That'll kind of keep things going smoothly. Now, you'll remember if from the end of your homework from lesson two, where we made a basic form. If we want to make a basic form, we can just return HTML directly from our handler here. So I'm going to add a quick string that represents an HTML form. I'm going to start with a triple quoted string. This is basically the Python syntax for a multi-line string. Anything I type between these two triple quotes will just be a part of a string, and including other quotes and such. So it makes it typing HTML a little bit easier. Okay, so a form tag. Remember, that just starts a form. A little h2 tag, that'll just add a little title. An input box, type text, and we'll give it the name food. And a button to add this food. Now, it looks like we're building some sort of food or shopping list sort of thing, and indeed we are. We'll kind of build there as we go. But for right now, we're just going to start with this basic form. So I've entered my form HTML. Let's make sure that our app returns this HTML. In effect, I'm going to rename this form HTML so it's a little bit easier to see down here. So let's replace this text with form HTML. And we'll give this a whirl in the browser. Reload the page. And I see a basic form. Now, recall that since we didn't set a method on that form, the default method is going to be get, which means when I submit this form, it'll just add that parameter to the URL. And let's go ahead and see that work. OK, so I typed in a food in the text box, and when I hit enter, the page reloaded with the food I just entered in the URL. Our first quiz is going to be, when I type in a new food in this text box and hit add, what happens? When I submit a new food in the text box, what happens? Choose the correct answer. The food parameter in the URL updates to match our new food. Do we see a second food parameter in the URL? So it'll have both steak and eggs in the URL, or does the browser report an error?